So earlier this month, this video went hugely viral. It's this crazy ass feminist from Russia, and she's just walking up on guys on the subway who are minding their own damn business, and she's pouring bleach all over their fucking crotch just because they got their legs spread a little bit. Basically, just committing a chemical attack on these dudes for no reason. Just like a crazy feminist would do. These fucking SJWs, they're proof the left has gone completely insane. You know, shit like this is exactly why Trump won. But immediately, as soon as I saw this, I took to Facebook to call bullshit on this. This video was obviously bullshit, and anybody with even an ounce of skepticism should have immediately seen through it. First off, supposedly she is dousing these guys with a Clorox solution that is 30 times more potent than you use to wash your clothes. All of these dudes would have immediately smelled it and know this bitch just doused them with chemicals, and not a single one of them hit her. Nobody grabbed her, nobody tackled her to the ground, nobody chased her ass down. And this is at a time where chemical attacks are on the rise in the world. People aren't just gonna sit idly by and let you douse them in chemicals. And the fact that she wasn't arrested and nobody pressed charges immediately set off my bullshit detector. At first, I just assumed she was an attention whore, trying to make a viral video to get popular and make money. Eventually, you see so much of this fake shit, it becomes easy to pick out. I even posted that I would not be entirely surprised if this turned out to be put out by the Russian government as propaganda. And a lot of people were like, hey man, that sounds like a conspiracy theory. And I agree, it actually does sound like a conspiracy theory. The difference is, I wasn't saying it was true. I wasn't saying that I know for a fact the Russian government put this out as propaganda. I was simply saying that this fits into their modus operandi. If you actually look into it, if you look into the troll farms and the bots and everything they were trying to do to sway the election, basically what they were trying to do was sow discord in the United States. They would have their troll bot farms even take both sides of the issue. They were trying to spread racial discord in our country. They were trying to spread anti-SJW propaganda. And they were basically just trying to divide Americans. That was their basic mission. They were trying to keep us at each other's throats so we would be too distracted to pay attention to the important issues. But I wasn't saying the Russians did. I was just saying that I would not be surprised. It's not a theory I was pushing. I was just saying that if evidence came out to support this in the future, it would not shock me. Then it turns out that's exactly what happened. Evidence came out suggesting this might be propaganda put out by the Russian government. First off, one of the dudes in the video came forward and said he was a paid actor. It was not really bleach they were pouring on him. It was just water. Then it came out that this video was originally released by In The Now, which is an arm of the Russian propaganda outlet Russia Today, a known Kremlin disinformation outlet. And then the Russian government, who has been trying to crack down on feminism, sent out one of their top politicians to declare feminism should be made illegal. And he called for feminists to be prosecuted under the law for 5-year prison sentences. So just saying, not to be conspiratorial, but this does look like it very well might have been put out by the Russian government. But let's say it wasn't. Let's say the Russian government had nothing to do with it. At the very least, this is nothing more than some attention whore who wanted to make a viral video to make money, so she hired people to be in it and faked pouring bleach on their crotches. This has nothing to do with actual leftists. This has nothing to do with actual feminism. This was simply a marketing ploy. But I knew what was gonna happen immediately. I knew immediately all the anti-SJW and conservative reactionaries were gonna jump all over this shit like a starving dog to a pork chop. And they're gonna use this to slam SJWs and the left to show everybody how crazy the left has gone. We didn't get pushed to the right because we're idiots, dudes. We got pushed to the right because all of this crazy SJW shit like in this video. So let's take a look at some of these geniuses who fell for this obvious hoax, shall we? First, let's check out this loud Australian cunt who swallowed this shit like it was a 10-inch cock.
One such social justice warrior in Russia decided it'd be a fantastic and necessary idea to head out to the St. Petersburg Metro train station, jump on a train, and then pour the chemical bleach onto strangers' laps. Social justice warriors are fucking everywhere. Social justice warriors spend their lives doing something that they do very well, playing the victim.
That's right, folks. The problem is not that he's a gullible meathead that can't see through an obvious hoax. The problem is leftist SJWs. Let's attack and demonize an entire group of people based on an obvious hoax. This video was seen over 300,000 times. This is exactly how this game is played, folks. These reactionaries don't know what the fuck they're talking about, and they put out this disinformation that is seen by hundreds of thousands and millions of people. And the few of these guys who actually do have the integrity to issue a retraction usually do it on places like Twitter or in videos that are seen far fewer times. So far, far, far fewer people see the retraction than see the actual smears. So the vast majority of people that see videos like this never realize it was a hoax to begin with. They never find out they were lied to by dipshits like this. But let's see who else fell for this obvious propaganda.
gets a water bottle, right? She fills it up with, like, half of bleach and half of water. Goes through every single man that she finds and with a little bit legs spread wide open. And just dumps bleach right on their crotches.
Feminism, right? Powers assemble!
Basically acid on their groin. This is, like, this is the point of feminism now. It's like, we need to have feminism in Russia. It's like, okay.
Oh my god, a guy's a mansplained. I'm gonna get out my pistol and shoot him. It's self-defense, right?
That's basically that. They can't produce children. You know that, right? Just picture half of your skin on your arm or your crotch. Dust. It's basically that.
This is why I hate third wave feminism. It's her
first feminism was all like, okay, you want women's rights? Okay, cool. Then you have it. Then the third wave comes out and no, it's all,
you know what? You looked at me weird. I'm gonna say you raped me at one point. Do you know that? And then guess what happens to the man? The man is all like, well, I didn't do it. Next year, the man is always getting like legit acid attacks now.
It's commonly accepted in the feminism part. About, hey, you know what? If you're a woman, you could do whatever you want to a man. If you feel the man did something to you that is unjustified, do you know what you should do? You should just assault men. Call them bad people. Say they raped you in your sleep when clearly you're a virgin, because that makes sense.
Feminist dudes, am I right? They're just going out there and assaulting men all over the place.
They've gone so crazy, they're going out there and they're burning dudes' nuts off to keep them from having children.
The left has lost their damn minds, dudes.
Why do I get the feeling that this kid thinks Steven Crowder is a comedic genius?
It's a hoax, dipshit. Never fucking happened.
Be more sophisticated, fucko. I know you want to believe this shit because it reinforces your preconceived notions. But be smarter.
G'day, cunts. Welcome to Lou Review. Today, we're going to take a look at a crazy Russian feminist who is fighting back against sexism with bleach. Just when you thought the social justice uprising of 2018 couldn't get any more insane, some crazy bitch from Russia just starts assaulting strangers on the train.
No, she didn't. You're dumb. You fell for a trick. You should be ashamed of yourself. Be more sophisticated.
I love that this woman has like made herself look like an idiot immediately with the first shot. Check this out. This dude isn't taking up much space because there are empty seats all throughout the carriage.
She's not the one who's making herself look like an idiot, dude. She's making you look like an idiot because she tricked you with some obvious bullshit.
If someone poured bleach on me, you'd think like you'd get up and push them or attack them. Like you don't know what chemical they're pouring on you.
You got a point there. You would think if this was real, the men would behave that way. And you'd also think the fact that they didn't might clue you in to the fact that this is fake as fuck. The outrage mob got outraged. Truth be damned.
She looks more shocked and more angry than the guy actually getting bleach poured all over his dick.
Yeah, it's almost like he's a paid actor.
What I don't get is like, all of this kind of stuff, sure, it gets heaps of views, but it doesn't make anyone agree with you. It just makes your entire movement and your whole argument look stupid.
God damn it, he's so close! Yes, that's exactly what it's supposed to do, you dumb motherfucker! It's propaganda meant to make the left look bad, so asshole reactionaries like you will jump on it, make YouTube videos, and push this narrative. You're 100% playing right into their fucking hands.
Because this video is so insane, a lot of people are debating at the moment whether or not it's actually real or if it's staged, but I honestly think it's real, and that's because this just seems like classically on brand for Russian feminism.
And it's even like, yeah, a lot of people say it's fake and the evidence suggests it's fake, but I really want to believe it, so therefore I do. That is not how you skeptic. And this person got incredibly excited about this video.
Now, understand how nobody hasn't killed this bitch yet. I'm just gonna be honest about it. So you telling me a bitch is out in public? It's something wrong with these broads? It's like, is bitches' minds like programmed all fucked up or something?
What the fuck are we staring at? And why are we talking like this?
Knock knock. Who's there? Be more sophisticated. And next up is right-wing blogger and conservative Stepford wife, Brittany Pettingbone. And if you guys needed even more proof that she's a robotic conservative Stepford wife, they cloned her! Look, there's two of her now.
20 years old, from Russia, female, obviously a feminist. And the stunt that she did was going in the metro and pouring a mixture of bleach and water on men as some kind of statement against manspreading.
The feminist tackled the quote-unquote disgusting act by splashing a mix of 30 liters of water and 6 liters of bleach into the groin areas of men she deemed to be sitting in an offensive manner. Yeah, this social activism is completely ineffective. And not only that, it paints this girl as like an unhinged lunatic. And I think it would probably even do the reverse of what she intended and perhaps cause more women to be maybe sympathetic towards manspreading.
Get out of town! Are you saying this obvious propaganda actually makes feminists look worse? And it's like they even know that it's fake. They know it's fake, but they don't even give a shit. They're like, yeah, we know these are paid actors, but it doesn't take away from the fact that this is what feminism actually wants to do. The fact that you know it's fake and you're still trying to use this to make feminists and the left look bad just show how shameless you are. You guys have no integrity. You're gonna jump on this and spread it anyway in order to try to make the left look bad and get yourself clicks and make money. You're shameless grifters. And even YouTuber Vegan Gains decided to jump on and spread this bullshit. And even though this situation has absolutely nothing to do with race whatsoever, somehow he still managed to find a way to use this to make fun of black women.
But there is a subcategory of woman spreading that I encountered on an almost daily basis, which is fat black woman spreading. And fat black women are not only inconsiderate because of the amount of space they're taking up, but also by offending everyone's eyesight with their clothing choices. And fat black women also tend to be pretty loud and obnoxious.
But don't worry, folks. His skin is sort of brown, so I'm pretty sure he can't be racist. And of course, the far-right media channel, The Rebel, bought this hook, line, and sinker, jumped on it immediately, and this video they put out actually got over 8 million views spreading this propaganda bullshit. And here's the thing about this. The Rebel actually admits that it's probably fake, but they're like, oh, it doesn't matter, because the liberal media is jumping on this and praising her for doing this.
Whether the video is a hoax or legitimate, the response from the feminist community and the mainstream media is very, very real. They are cheering on Dovgalyuk, and they could inspire more copycat attacks. Dovgalyuk is getting a very warm reception from the feminist community for apparently pouring bleach on male strangers because they are manspreading. Dovgalyuk's attacking these men who are very clearly depicted as minding their own business because they aren't keeping their legs in a way she and her feminist leg police cohorts want them to. It's so weird. Let's be real. These are acid attacks if they happened. Targeted acid attacks on men because they are men doing what men do.
Actually looked around, the original video has been seen like 20 million times or something like that. I read through thousands of comments, could not find anybody supporting this woman. I read article after article from the lamestream left-wing media, couldn't find anybody fucking praising this woman. But the Rebel media just told you right there that lots of people were praising her. So clearly they're gonna give lots of examples here to prove their point, right? Wrong! They absolutely provided zero evidence of their claim here. Watch this video for yourself. They showed absolutely nobody praising this bullshit. It's absolutely possible there might be a few crazy nuts out there who support this woman, but to claim it's widespread is an absolute fucking lie. Being a lefty myself, I don't know a single fucking lefty who supports this. And I think there's a very good reason the Rebel did not actually give any examples whatsoever. They're just lying fucks. And let's see what's up next. I sure hope it's another cookie-cutter anti-SJW channel who uses a cartoon avatar in a really condescending voice.
Violence. This is violence. It's the same with any oppressor. You use violence to keep the people down, and eventually they push back. That is inevitable.
Oh, goody! Anyway, folks, there are so many examples of this, I could really go on all day. Conservative, reactionary YouTube bit on this, and they bit hard. And this is why a couple years ago, I started moving away from the anti-SJW community and started speaking out against them. It's because as I began to look into a lot of the things they were sharing, a lot of things they were spreading, so much of it turned out to be absolutely fake. Hell, even popular conservative YouTuber Blair White recently made a video where she admitted that other conservative bloggers and vloggers she hung out with admitted to her that they were faking stuff. They were faking some of these protests against them. They were hiring people to protest them in order to up the outrage and play the victim. And hell, Blair White herself actually blocked me because I pointed out that she had posted something on her Twitter that was false. And her response to me was basically that she didn't give a shit if it was false or not. She was going to leave it up forever because it triggered me. And then she blocked me when I called her out for it. So that seems to be the attitude that so many of these anti-SJW types have. They don't really give a shit if it's true or not. They don't really research much of what they post and spread. Their entire goal seems to be just acting like the biggest pieces of shit they can possibly act like in order to own the libs. And honestly, I wish we could just ignore this shit, but we can't. Because what this does, this hypes everybody up, makes them feel like the left is the crazy ones and they have to vote for the right. They have to support right-wing candidates and policies. But the truth is, lefties like me were actually incredibly reasonable people. The policies we support are actually really popular with the American people. None of us give a shit if you fucking manspread. Yeah, BuzzFeed, who are idiots, I might have done an article about this a couple years ago, but that's just clickbait bullshit. This is not real. The majority of lefties like me just want common sense shit. Like universal health care, like affordable education, and Wall Street reforms, and environmental protections, and worker protections, and a narrowing of the wealth inequality in this country, and a robust social safety net that helps the poorest and most vulnerable among us. And instead, what's happening is so many of you are being brainwashed by this propaganda bullshit against the left that many of you are being pushed to the right and you're actually supporting right-wing candidates that have policies that do not benefit your life. Giving $1.5 trillion in tax cuts to billionaires does not benefit you. Eroding environmental protections does not benefit you. Bankrupting our country with higher military spending does not benefit you. So please, folks, be more sophisticated. Do not keep falling for this fake bullshit. Stop letting them feed you propaganda and distract you from the actual issues. It's way past time to start seeing through this con game. Because this stuff is not complicated, folks. It's really fucking easy to see through. And before I go, I just want to say that somebody brought it to my attention that Armored Skeptic did a video similar to this. I had planned to do this video 3 weeks ago, but I took 3 weeks off to play with kittens and to raise them, because my life is awesome. But I did not see Armored Skeptic's video, so any similarities between his video and mine is completely coincidental. As always, thanks for joining me. I love you guys, and until next time, logic. Fuck yes. Hey guys, Dusty Smith here, and as you see, these cute-ass kittens are getting bigger. As always, if you enjoy what I do, please consider supporting me on Patreon. We do a lot of good work here at the Humanist Society of Mississippi Animal Sanctuary, and every little bit really helps. Thanks, guys. Love you. Mwah. Kitties!